Welcome to Love and Money Secrets TV. Over my lifetime, I have had, like you, a number of dreams that make you go, whoa, what was that all about? I didn't know when I was a kid or in my 20s, but in my 30s, it became very apparent that as I had friends and even people who worked, you know, with or for me, that it turns out that I happened to just instinctively know what those dreams meant. Now for myself, sometimes I'll have a dream and at first I'm in a quandary where like, I have no idea what this means, but I know that in time it'll be revealed to me. And so at the beginning of 2019, my boyfriend, who I loved very dearly, broke up with me very unexpectedly in a very harsh way and very nonsensical way. Now, rewind the tape. I said 2019. At the end of 2018, just I'd say 4 months before, yeah, it was 4 months before, I had a couple dreams. And so without naming any names, we were actually out of town, we had traveled. And I had this dream where I was laying down and I tried to tell him, but I couldn't speak. It was a very lucid dream where it felt like it was real. For those of you who've had lucid dreams, you'll acknowledge that, yeah, it doesn't feel like a dream. It feels like it's really happening to you. So in the dream, I couldn't speak, and I told him to help me, but I couldn't speak to him, and I could not move. And then I was laughing down and unable to get up. I tried to get up, but I couldn't. And then I woke up. Then I woke up because he said, hey, hey, hey. So I must have said something where he knew that I was having some sort of a dream. So the next dream I had, which was that same evening, normally I don't have 2-3 dreams in an evening, but this one I happened to. So I dreamt that same night, which I barely got any sleep, that he jumped into a vent in the floor and disappeared. And all I saw were traces of red smoke. So the reason why I'm sharing this with you is because those dreams were trying to warn me. They were trying to let me know of what was to come. And I did have the thought when I saw the second dream specifically. Well, the first dream, it was evident to me that in the dream, he couldn't help me, but in real life, I knew that he couldn't help me. That's obviously, you know, it seems very obvious to me. The second dream meant that he was gonna leave. That's why he disappeared into a vent, and then there was just red smoke. Red smoke means anger. Sure enough, 4 months later, he's on his laptop, and all of a sudden he explodes in a fit of anger. And of course, that's how he left and basically disappeared. And so those dreams were warning me of what I already instinctively knew. And so that's what those dreams were there, were to inform me. I had somebody who yesterday, and the reason why I'm doing this particular video today is because yesterday I had a mother who has a daughter who her daughter had been dating her fiance, then boyfriend. They started dating when they were 15 years old, and now she's 26 years old. Over the last several years, they bought a house together, they've made all these plans, they've been living together, and now, I think just a week or two or less before the day of the wedding, because they're supposed to get married, he basically doesn't even have the courage to see her face to face. He basically texts her, I guess, from work and says, I don't love you anymore. I don't want to get married. I don't want to be in a relationship. Yada, 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 yada. So needless to say, this girl is devastated because she has spent 11 years of her life since she was 15 years old with this guy. And so this is obviously something that is there to show her and to grow her. And so that's what prompted this video. Because the other thing is, the mom told me that her daughter had had a dream about her, about him leaving her just prior to this happening. And so she had an instinct, and her heart, her spirit was trying to let her know there's something not right. So my biggest message to you here is pay attention. If you have a misgiving about something, if you have something that isn't quite right, I've had this all my life, we all have. And in business, I would not question it, but in my personal life, I wasn't as sure-footed and secure. And that, this year, that was taken care of. Because I actually scientifically tested my intuition time after time after time after time. I would have a sense of something, I would take it into meditation, I would bring it into my heart space, I would get my heart and my brain coherent. And it was amazing, the confirmations and the revelations that I had. And then I never expected to have something blatantly obvious present itself to me, but it was amazing to me how often I would have confirmation and I would know without a shadow of a doubt that my intuition was 100% spot on. That being said, I'm not gonna tell you, oh, if you're betting on the races and you wanna gamble X amount of dollars, you know, to ask me. No, I'm not a fortune teller, I'm not a psychic, that's not what this is about. I'm telling you that you have this ability within you. And just like I needed to stop denying myself and doubting myself with my personal things, because in business I didn't have this issue, but in my personal life, there really is no separation between one or the other, but it's the way I was thinking about it. So I recognize that the way I was thinking about it wasn't serving me. My ego was doing a number on me. My ego is not my amigo. Now, I am on purpose with laser-like focus. I have my mind. I think of the most loving thought towards myself, and I command my brain to shut that ego's mouth. There's no room for that. Thank you. That is there for contrast. That's how we used to do things. And now I am commanding you. I am the master. You're the servant. And now the brain, which is the organ that signals to wire and fire new neurological pathways in the brain, it's what triggers the autonomic nervous system to create a pharmacopoeia of up to 140,000 chemicals, including proteins to upregulate and downregulate whatever genes you have in your body so that you express or depress. You either will manifest and express certain traits, or they will be recessive and inactive. So you can cure and heal, whether it's trauma, whether it's disease, whether it's a syndrome, whether it's injury, whether it's emotional, spiritual, psychological, doesn't matter. This is where the power is. This is where the formula is, okay? So that's what I wanted to share with you today. Thank you for tuning in, tapping in, turning on to Love and Money Secrets TV. And I am filming this from the beautiful romantic city, and it is beautiful and romantic, of Rome, Italy. So, ciao for now. California, cell phone, woohoo!